Girl is a Half Home Thing is my debut novel, and it's set in Ireland in the late 80s and the early 90s. And it's a story about a brother and a sister. The brother has had a brain tumour in early childhood, and it's left him affected mentally. And the story is really about the girl's relationship with him, with his illness, the after effects of it, and then later on about being abused by an older family member. And it really follows her from in the womb to the age of 20, and is about her dealing with those two issues. I'm very interested in modernism and in the way that tradition can be used to explain the female experience, to more deeply describe it. And what I wanted to do with writing the book and the way that I wrote it was to take down the barriers between the reader and the character, to take the narrator out, the writer out of the experience for the reader, and make the reader feel much closer to the character, almost as though the experiences the character was going through were happening inside their own body. So they felt very, very close to her and less able to stand back and make judgments about her. I certainly found that linear language, grammatical language, seemed inadequate to really fully describe those kind of experiences. And I felt quite frustrated that in English there are so few ways to describe things, which, you know, maybe in German you can, you know, they have their sort of enormous compound nouns and they can, you know, just create a word that very, very specifically means something, and you can't do that in English. And so it was really about trying to make language creep over the edges of itself. I sat down to write the book with a very different idea in my head, which was really a plagiarism of Ulysses, but set in London and about a girl. Of course, nothing happened because it wasn't my idea. It was nothing to do with me. But one day I hit upon the first words of A Girl is a Half-Formed Thing. And then I understood that that's where the book would go. I just followed the voice, and it really built itself image by image. So in a way, if the reader feels there's a sense of urgency in the text, that's because there was. I wrote the book very quickly. I wrote it in 6 months. I did 3 drafts in 6 months and immediately started to send it out, feeling sure that all the world would be desperate for this book about this girl and all these things that happened to her, and was very quickly disabused of that idea when I started to receive rejection letters, which were not the rejections that I was expecting, which would have been, I don't like it, or I don't understand it, or it doesn't work, or whatever, but were rejections that said, this is great, but we don't know how to sell this book. Or, we really like this book, but our marketing department says we can't because this doesn't fit anywhere. Which was very disheartening, because I understood that it was not my problem. It was a wider problem within publishing. And after about 5 years, I put the manuscript in the drawer and decided, or had to decide, whether being unpublished and possibly unpublishable meant that I was still a writer. And then I just realized, even if I was a failed writer, I couldn't really do anything better. So I'd better start on the next novel, which I did. And I didn't expect A Girl is a Half-Formed Thing to get published at that point. So 9 years after I had written A Girl is a Half-Formed Thing, my husband and I moved to Norwich in the east of England for his work. And one day he was in the independent bookshop in the centre of Norwich called The Book Hive, and got talking to the man behind the counter, Henry Late, who asked what his wife did, and he told him the long tale of my voyage into failure. And Henry said, that's very interesting, because some friends and I are thinking of setting up an independent press of our own. Would she let us read it? Which I did, thinking that nothing would happen. I'd sent it to big presses, I'd sent it to independent presses, and nothing had ever happened. But they liked it. And they came back and said, okay, we're just about to publish our first book. We don't have any money. We don't know what we're doing, but we really like your book. When we know a bit more, can we come back? And I said, okay. And again, didn't think that I would ever hear from them again. But a year later, they came back and they said, we still have no money. We know a little bit more about what we're doing. What do you think? Shall we do it? And I said yes. And that's how the book finally got to be published 9 years later. Well, a book I'd certainly recommend is The Vegetarian by the South Korean writer Han Kang. It's very beautifully written. The language is incredibly sensual and interesting, but also deals with some very brutal, difficult issues and is very kind of darkly sexual and quite disturbing, but a really wonderful read for anyone who's open to something like that.